Hello friends, can you help me solve a puzzle? The puzzle is about the rabbit breeding problem, which states that a certain man put a pair of rabbits in a place surrounded on all sides by a wall. How many pairs of rabbits can be produced from that pair in a year? If it is supposed that every month each pair begets a new pair, which from the second month on become productive. Let's first understand and try to solve this problem. In the first month, we had only one pair of rabbits. In the second month, this pair will produce one pair of offspring. Then the first pair will have another pair of offspring in the third month. And the second pair is now mature. Thus, in the third month, we have one pair of baby rabbits and two pairs of adult rabbits. Next, two mature pairs will give two pairs of offspring in the fourth month, and the baby pair will be matured now. So, there will be two baby pair rabbits and three mature pairs of rabbits in the fourth month. We get five mature rabbits in the fifth month. And each of the three that matured in the previous month has contributed a baby pair. The three previously immature ones will have matured and can be added to the previous five in the sixth month. Thus, we have eight mature pairs and five pairs of baby rabbits in the sixth month. Do you see the emerging pattern? Each new number is obtained by adding the previous two numbers. So let us continue this pattern until the 12th month. So there will be total 233 pairs of rabbits at the end of the year. Do you know what this pattern is called? This pattern is called the Fibonacci sequence, in which the next number is found by adding the previous two numbers. But why the name Fibonacci? Well, Fibonacci was a great mathematician around 800 years ago. He wrote a book called Liber Abaci, in which he asked about this question, the rabbit breeding problem. Do you know his real name was Leonardo the Pisa? And Fibonacci is his nickname. So let's see some fun facts and applications of Fibonacci numbers in our day-to-day life. First is, Fibonacci Day is celebrated on November 23rd. Do you know why? No, it's not because it's Fibonacci's birthday, but because if you write November 23rd in MMDD, that is month and date format, then it forms the Fibonacci sequence. Another exciting feature of the Fibonacci sequence is its close relationship to the golden ratio, which is approximately 1.618. The sequential Fibonacci number ratio is close to the golden ratio. You can watch our video, What's the Golden Ratio, for more information. I'll include the link in the description box. Now, the most common application of Fibonacci number is a Fibonacci retracement, which is used by technical traders. A Fibonacci retracement is a popular tool that helps identify strategic places for transactions, stop losses, or target prices to help stock market and commodity traders get in at a good price. The Fibonacci sequence is used widely in Western harmony and musical skills. Also, in many natural things like flowers, snails, etc., you can observe the Fibonacci pattern. Now, add a comment and tell us where you have seen the Fibonacci sequence in nature and our day-to-day life. So, if you like this session, then hit the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more such videos. So, keep learning with Letstute. Thank you.